with us Mr. Vinod Pandey. Mr. Pandey has done his MA from Delhi University. He is a certified associate of Indian Institute of Bankers. He holds a diploma in business management from Narasimhaji Institute of Management and Studies and international capital markets qualification from Security Institute London. Mr. Pandey is general manager with SBI presently on deputation to SBI Capital Markets Limited as executive vice president and regional North East India. He has worked in various assignments in SBI, which include an assignment with the bank's branch in Hong Kong. He has also worked in the treasury management group of international banking division of the bank at corporation office, Mumbai, prior to his deputation in SBI Caps. He was DGM and head SBI New Delhi main branch, one of the largest branches of the bank in India. May I now request Professor Ashish Pandey to kindly present the bouquet to Mr. Vinod Pandey.
We have a very terrible crisis at the Maruti factory in Gurgaon recently. The ambiguous labor laws are partly to blame for some of the recent trouble in the country. Wages are too low for the unorganized sector and too high comparatively for the organized sector. The unorganized sector are largely at a subsistence level and they have nothing to look forward to, no social security at all. Indian business also is plagued right now with a lot of debtors because with the markets being low, the economy being almost down, debtors are a big problem for Indian business. The uncertainties of recovery still plagues Indian business. There is no revenue growth taking place because most businesses are feeling a heat of sales drop and the customers shying away. Economies of scale is another thing which has hit India and Indian businesses. Most businesses are feeling the heat as sales drop and customers are going away. Completion of a project is also an issue. A project takes so much time to complete due to the various factors including cash crunch, shortage of funds, high cost of funds, etc. These are the general issues that are plaguing Indian business. I would now like to take care of some of the sectoral issues facing different sectors in the country. The most important sectors which need growth in the country are the power sector, the road sector, the steel sector, and of course airline sector is already in turmoil. Though the power sector offers ample opportunities, it is plagued by a lot of uncertainties. The major uncertainty for power sector, especially the thermal power sector, is the coal linkage issue. Coal India is not able to provide enough coal linkages to the power, to the thermal power plants that are coming in. That has created a lot of difficulty in new power projects coming up. Cost of, in fact, what has happened is now the thermal power plants are going in for imported coal. Cost of imported coal is very, very high and also it is subject to the policy changes of the exporting countries like it happened in Indonesia. A lot of Indian thermal power plants, they bought some coal mines in Indonesia, which was very cheap, much cheaper than the Indian coal. And suddenly the Indonesian government realized that we are selling off our mineral resources at a very cheap rate. So they changed the laws and the cost of coal in Indonesia is now as high as it is in India. Apart from that, the domestic banks have almost reached their limits as far as the power sector is concerned. That has created a crisis for funds by the power sector. Land acquisition issues remain. High cost of funds are there for the power sector, for the power plants to come up. And so not many new power plants are really being commissioned. The other sector that is plaguing and that is very important for the country, road sector. This sector has the maximum potential and the maximum uncertainty. Land acquisition remains the major uncertainty for the road sector. Recently, NHAI has introduced aggressive bidding and that has made projects very, very unviable. Unless lenders are sure of the viability of a project, they will not be willing to lend. That is a major issue with the road sector. Another thing that is plaguing the concessionaire is that the concession period is not aligned to the debt providing capacity of the lender. Normally, a lender will give funds for 10 to 15 years, but the concession period is about 30 years, and that makes the lenders very wary of giving loans to the road sector. There is a need to introduce alternate sources of funding as well, because for a road sector you need long-term funds. Lenders, typically banks, will give you funds only for 10 to 15 years. You need funds for about 30 years. What we should do is maybe create some depth in the bond market. Apart from that, we need some more involvement in the bond market by the insurance sector and the pension sector. The pension funds and the insurance funds need to invest in the bonds which are issued by the concessionaires of the road projects. We at SBI Cap have been in discussion with some pension funds in other countries as well, so that they can invest in the infrastructure sector, which needs funds for a long term. The other sector which has not done well and which is not doing well right now, facing a lot of uncertainties, is the steel sector. When funds were cheap, the steel plants, they increased their capacity, they built excess capacity, and now there is a glut. Then we have the airline sector, which is in doldrums. The potential of the sector has been choked by very high prices. And apart from that, exorbitant operating costs owing to high airport taxes and fuel taxes. Fuel taxes in India add about 30% to their bill. Fuel accounts for about 45% of the total operating costs in India, whereas abroad it is only 33%. So we have seen that some of the major sectors which really need growth are facing a lot of uncertainty. Now, what is the solution? I think a lot of steps have been taken, reform measures have been taken recently by the government, and I'm sure if these reform measures that have been taken are sustained or implemented, I think some of these uncertainties can be taken care of. In a welcome step, Ministry of Corporate Affairs recently constituted a committee headed by the former chairman of SEBI, Mr. Damodaran, to reform the business and regulatory environment in India. I think Mr. Damodaran is a very is an excellent person to head a committee like this. And once his report comes, I'm sure the government will take action and improve the environment in the country. That is all I'd like to say about the financial uncertainties facing the Indian businesses. And of course, when we have questions, then we will try to find those. Thank you.